Okay, so why is pop music so addictive?
You know that song I've been playing the last few days, Lennon?
Yeah, Don't Call Me Up.
Don't Call Me Up.
You like it?
Yeah.
Why do you like it?
Because it has singing in it.
I don't know, because you're going to do a video on it.
Hey, Dylan.
Yes?
You know that song, Don't Call Me Up?
Don't Call Me Up, that one?
Yeah, why do you think I like that?
I have no idea.
Okay, if you don't know the song we're talking about, it's this.
When I'm underneath the bright lights, when I'm trying to have a good time, cause I'm good.
This is by the artist Mabel.
Don't call me up when you're looking at my photos.
I was listening to it the other day and I was trying to figure out, why do I like this song? It's got a basic chord progression that starts it out.
When I'm underneath the bright lights,
B minor to A major to E major. But there's a couple subtle things in there that actually grab your ear right off the bat. There's this little suspension on the B minor that goes. And then on the A major, it goes. It goes from A major to A sus 2. And then it goes right down the E major triad. But what Mabel is singing there on that second chord on the A major is a momentary dissonance, the fourth, the note D, which is the fourth of A major against that C sharp. You hear that brief rub of that half step.
When I'm underneath the
when she's singing that, the piano moves, or the keyboard part moves from C sharp to B, and that note is a dissonance against the C sharp. And then it becomes a very strong minor third interval here from B to D. It grabs your ear. You don't know it's grabbing your ear, but it actually does. That's the first little spot that hooks you. B minor, A major, E major. That's it right there. A little change there. Got no rhythm yet. Now.
Don't call me up. I'm going out.
Well, one thing that's good is that the mix sounds phenomenal on it, but that's not why I like it. That's not what catches my ear. There's a couple things right off the bat, I think, that really grab me, that I think to grab anyone. And it's funny, people always ask me, why do you like pop music? You like all this weird modern classical music. You like jazz. You like progressive rock. You like metal. Why do you like pop music? Well, it's a producer thing. There's a part of my brain that just appreciates things that are really well done and well crafted. I almost can't help it. And it makes me want to figure out, what is it in there that makes me want to listen to it? This is where what makes this song great comes from, because I'm always asking that question. Or even, what makes this song great to other people? Maybe that's even the better question. But in the verse, there's a really interesting,
na, 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 na.
Right there, when she goes down to that G sharp. Listen to this.
Cause I'm good now, you ain't mine. Na, 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 na.
So there's a move where it goes, you're hearing this D, C sharp, down to G sharp. And it goes to G sharp and the E chord. That move is really odd. You don't really hear that, cause you're really, your ear's kind of picking up that D down to G sharp, that tritone.
Cause I'm good now, you ain't mine. Nah, 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 nah. Don't call me up when you're looking.
And that's the first time
photos
that the hook is stated.
Hot,
and it actually has a very catchy rhythm to it.
Da 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 da.
Okay. We get the snaps in here. But I'm not hooked yet. But I like it that. I'm thinking, okay. This is a really common thing now. Songs have gotten so sophisticated, and you're thinking, like, that's not sophisticated. You just did Dance on a Volcano by Genesis. The sophistication is in the arrangement and the melodic hooks, the very subtle hooks, really specifically talking about when things are removed and things are added. Songs like this have become really compressed, and I don't mean just squished with a limiter. I mean, they're also compressed in how often hooks happen in them. The song's also compressed in time. It's only 2 minutes and 58 seconds long. This is why you'll see 10 songwriters and 3 producers on a song, because it takes a team of scientists to come up with the right formula to addict the masses to these songs. One of the things I've noticed current producers doing a lot of are these sudden dynamic changes by removing instruments on sections, having a piano or a little pad going on, and then on the next section, dropping in with a bass and drums, like this. Here, you have this high piano that comes in with a little string pad, and then... Now there's no snare on 2 and 4, really. Upbeats. Pedal. Hand claps. This song sounds great on your phone, on headphones, but in the car, it sounds massive. The kick and bass are perfectly married. The kick provides the pulse, and the bass fills in with that low extension. It just fills up your whole car. People that really like songs like this, that like pop music, they notice those things. They don't notice them consciously, but they notice them. That goes to D there and holds for a second. That's one of the only times it changes. Then you have your different sound on 2 and 4. There's your real strong 2 and 4. Then it gets a little more action and rhythmically. There's a little sound effect there that drag you into that section. But we're going to have another change here. Right here. Suspends the sound because there's no low register here. It's floating. And then it drops you back into the groove. Don't call me up. I'm going out tonight. Feeling good now you're out of my life. Don't want to talk about us. And hear those little percussive sounds. There's also some subtle changes that happen here where it goes. The choices of where those notes are, those little dissonances that happen, are really crucial. Then you have that little drum fill with the break, and you leave the break for the hook line. I keep saying it, this is science. You have a human voice that's been really auto-tuned, even though Mabel's a very good singer. You have all synthetic instruments. There's not a real instrument on here. There's synthesizers, there's programmed bass, there's programmed drums. People have put this on a grid, and it's been assembled with a team of people. This is actually a small team of people, 3 writers and 1 producer. To me, the songs that have less people are the ones that actually are better songs. I think this is a very well-written song. It has just enough unpredictability. But if you use the food comparison that this is essentially junk food, pop music today is junk food because of the incredibly simple diatonic, meaning it doesn't change keys, chord progressions, really simplistic melodies. A steady diet of this music, I think, ultimately leads to attrition and your inability to actually absorb something that's nutritious. And when I say nutritious, I think something like this. It's very easy to dismiss incredibly simple pop music that is manufactured essentially like junk food. It's really easy to do that. But junk food is put together by scientists. Oreos didn't just appear out of nowhere. McDonald's hamburgers with all the salt, with all the fat, are made to overwhelm your taste buds. That's what they do. And they leave you wanting more. But essentially, you all know that feeling that after you've eaten it, about an hour later, where you say to yourself, what was I thinking? I believe that music like this does this to you as well. But it's a very slow and steady process. In order to keep people's attention, you have to have these rapid-fire hooks, register changes, repetitive rhythms, explicit language. Almost everything at the top of Spotify has the explicit warning on them, except for this song, actually. All these different things to really keep people focused in on the song and have a melody that grabs you over and over again with these little dissonances that are found there. It's very sophisticated stuff. Remember, they're scientists. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel if you're interested in the Beato book. Follow me on Instagram at RickBeato1. Thanks for watching.